Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Murder on Eridanos Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, now at the Meteorological Center or something? Control Station. I'm supposed to meet someone here, so let's refresh my memory and yours. Okay, you've discovered that Black Hole Bertie may have wanted to kill Halcyon Helen. Investigate what he was doing at the time of the murder. Someone broke into your penthouse, they're rummaging through your things, are you going to let them get away with it? Right. So the Rizzo's Rangers mascot was sent by Black Hole Bertie to search the penthouse. He refused to speak more about it inside the hotel, insisting you meet him at the weather monitoring station on the Phaeton pilot house. So that's where we are now. Cheers.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Oh. There's a dead person.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Ranger mascot's noggin. Vending machine power cables. Power cables. Vending machine power cables not presently in use by any vending machines. What else do we pick up? Oh, it's a thing. It's a helmet thing. This unique helmet was worn by a particularly hyperactive mascot. There were some small blood stains inside. At least it's probably blood. Interesting, it gives block plus 10 and inspiration plus 10. I don't know where in that. Let's see, armor stinky. Alright, so we're gonna identify that body. In a second.
You'll have to show me how to do that.
Yeah, I can't do them all. There's a bunch lately that I can't open. And I think it's Felix in the party who helps with that. I traded him out for Max, so Max could help with the hacking. So I might have to bring... I mean, if I'm correct, I'll have to bring Max and Felix. So that I can pick locks and hack. Because, you know, best of both worlds.
Discrepancy detected. Rizzo's company policy clearly states that all proprietary mascots must exhibit signs of physical life.
Okay, we know for sure he was the mascot. I mean, I figured he was. Well, he's got another one of those little arms coming out of his neck, I guess. But it's just, you know, puncture wounds near his collarbone. Rizzo's company policy? Really? What are they gonna do, fire him on account of being dead?
In accordance with Rizzo's company policy, after removing any extraneous blood and viscera, this mascot's uniform will be assigned to his successor. Medical analysis complete. This mascot was likely killed by small arms fire at close range. The firearm is unique and does not exist in this unit's database.
Well, he probably turned into like one of those effusive hosts or something and went after somebody. Maybe, because he's got the thing sticking out. Well, it's the smallest caliber ammunition I've ever seen. These are small wounds.
Unusually small entry wounds indicate exotic weaponry. Closest approximations are 1. Incident involving a game of darts. 2. The Needler.
The Needler. Isn't that a gun I had at one point? The Needler?
Yes, Inspector. The Needler. Bespoke handgun carried and wielded by Halcyon Helen. Famously deployed by Halcyon Helen in Terror on Monarch. This weapon was responsible for executing the Chief of the Savages, played by Spencer Woolridge.
Amplifier, before we go, do you think he'd miss his outfit?
This unit is incapable of providing ethical advice. This unit is also incapable of answering rhetorical questions.
Well, you're not very helpful then, are you? I'll take his things. It's, potential evidence. You glance over your shoulder to see if anyone's watching, then reach down and remove the mascot's gear. Well, Ellie and Max seeming. What? It's potential evidence. Look at me in that tone of voice. Armored tossball uniform. This modified armor is no longer regulation. Not even an eighth back needs this much protection. Anything important? I got cables. Alright, he took the helmet, I guess. This wasn't the meeting spot. The meeting spot is down. I think the meeting was off.
I can take a hint.
You take that hint. There's something else to look at. The thing's like... Oh, wait.
This empty bottle of spirits does not belong to any known corporate brand. Suspicious residue detected.
High concentration of ethanol. Someone's brewing moonshine with antiseptics.
Excellent deduction, Inspector. Imbibing of unauthorized beverages is strictly prohibited under Rizzo's company law. Ingredients include antiseptic alcohol, sucrose, and unidentifiable miscellaneous organic material. Closest match. Counterfeit spirits available at the Piraeus spaceport.
Interesting. The leads you found in the pilot house weather station indicate that Bertie had planned to meet the mascot there and is now hiding out at the spaceport's cantina. Oh, so he's not in here. Just because we found that there. Oh, okay. We're not just gonna leave, we're gonna finish exploring this place. Oh, hello again. Okay. These are steals. Okay, very nice, very nice.
Hey, you can see into the hotel rooms with that thing.
Oh, really?
Hey, you can see into the hotel rooms with that thing.
I heard you the first time. And I'm trying to see in the hotel rooms, but it won't let me. Phaeton. So, maybe someone had a view of the whole killing. Maybe it was Bertie Holcomb. Lettering looks backwards. Yay, stuff to read. I get the feeling there's something else in here to pick up. But I don't see anything. I'm used to there being tons of loot, like, just laying all over the place. Oh, not in this case. Alright. Meteorological Observation Station. Rizzos reminds you that all equipment is to be used for the express purposes of monitoring Eridanos weather patterns. Use of monitoring equipment for any other purpose is expressly prohibited. Logs. Station logs. Day 523, clear skies. Day 524, distant storm. Phaeton steered around it. Day 525, distant storm. Phaeton adjusted course. Day 526, clear skies. 527, clear skies. Day 528, distant storm. Phaeton revised heading. Day 529, clear skies. Okay, so we do the hack for the unofficial logs. I've password locked this directory. Pretty sure no one in management can crack it, even if they do start checking up on us. Have fun. Pete. Oh, interesting. Okay, station bingo and celebrity sightings. I saw Spencer Woolrich order 4 different meals and send them all back. What a refined palate. H. The other day, Halcyon Helen was enjoying a spectrum on the terrace. The stars really are just like the rest of us. P. Some of the rangers started tussling in one of the fountains. The gardener Automex spent hours propping the flowers back up. What fun, guys. D. I wonder if this was the last time she was seen. She was drinking a spectrum vodka of some kind. Station bingo. Initial if you see one of the following on your shift. First to 3 wins. Teacup canids and matching outfits. D. This should really count twice, one for each canid. Someone falling off edge of island. Oh god. Tryst in greenhouse. H. It's all windows. Why would anyone do this? Exhibitionists, maybe. Pteroray slams into hotel window. D. Raptodon or primal on hotel island. Oh, we've been seeing plenty of those. Okay. Well, that's it for the Meteorological Control Station. Center. Control Center? It's not that door closed. I'm like, he opened the door again. Since I'm here, might as well look around some more. The coffee stain blends in with your lapel. Oh,
that means you can still see it.
But anyone who sees it will know that you can afford the expensive stuff.
Don't look at me. I'm gonna back you up on this one. Whoops. Pteroray's. Wonderful. Run me. What's some kind of cage here? Oh, look, hidden stuff. Whoop. Oh, it's a steel. It's for me. Did I shoot one of them down? I was shooting at them, but I didn't see any over here that like were attacking. Exterior engine. Is that what that is? I'm trying to figure out what's in this cage. Am I crazy? Nope, I don't like those things. That's the camp. I've been over there. There's another one. Oh, is that the same one? I don't think so. Was the other one over here? Yeah. Someone's been killing these things. Someone besides me. So this is the navigation deck. Comfy? East Museum. Oh, start here. Okay. Phaeton Control, West Museum. I can't click the thing for a little audio. Start here.
My last quarterly review said I had an attitude problem. Morale improvement program fixed me right up.
He'd probably turn you into a zombie or something. Am I safe in here? I hope so. I'm waiting to get charged by a fusive host or something. Noisy over here. Did you hear that? I got monsters. These are big people. Authentic Rizzo's armor. I was hoping it would repeat it to me in a like a narrator voice. With over 30 articulated joints and reinforced plating in purpleberry pink and nanner blue. Nanner should be yellow. Rizzo's guards enjoy the most fashionable armors in all of Halcyon. These brave troops show their corporate pride whether they're battling dissidents, guarding factories, or simply giving our workers a friendly pep talk. Sure, that's what they're doing. Raise a glass of lemon slap to show your support for the corporate soldiers who protect us all. Yes, and harass the hell out of you. Where's those products? Hi.
Bertie Holcomb is likely beside himself in grief.
Oh yeah, him. The fabulous Bertie the Black Hole Holcomb of the Rizzo's Rangers. This tossball stick was used by none other than Bertie Black Hole Holcomb during the historic match between Rizzo's Rangers and the Happydale Farmers, where Bertie's triple tackle of rival hacker Claude the Bull Payne set the record for the most simultaneous rule violations. Champions like Bertie stay energized with Rizzo's Purpleberry Munch. Be like Bertie. Enjoy your favorite Rizzo's product today. No, I will not. Rizzo Rangers hacker uniform? Will this help me do hacking? Don't look at me like that. I need hacking. Oh, it's not that kind of hacking, huh? Only a melee damage plus 10% bonus. Tossball hackers hurt other people. You should try that too. Oh, I already do that. I'll do plenty of that, thank you. You see, there are butts now.
Must you read every law forsaken sign in the building?
I thought you were talking to me.
Some of us enjoy learning things.
Oh, yeah? And what did you learn about Rizzo's armor 2 hours ago?
It's not about memorizing, it's about absorbing. Okay?
Hmm. Let's absorb the one that says exit.
Hi.
Mr. Kincannon really knows how to run a hotel.
Yeah.
I was nearly attacked by a Pteroray on my way here.
Yep, everyone was. Join the club. Hey, what's this? Purpleberry trees. Can you imagine life without Purpleberry Bunch? Purpleberry Crunch? Purpleberry Fizzy... Okay, I'm gonna leave out the Purpleberry word. Fizzy tea, juice, liqueur, lunch, munch, punch, or wine? We sure can't. That's why the hard-working brand managers of Rizzo's developed the... Purpleberry, an irresistible fruit with more sugar and less fiber than anything you'll find in nature. Why not book a tour for Purpleberry Orchards and treat yourself to a Rizzo's product today? You deserve it. I don't want to say Purpleberry that many times. Thank you very much. Are we going to get attacked here? There's explodey things. Set up.
Stop. You're smudging the glass.
That wasn't me.
That is definitely the shape of your nose.
Huh.
I didn't mean to.
Hush! You'll get me in trouble.
You're in trouble. Come with me. Rizzo's mostly natural super grow formula. How much do we have to have in order for it to be mostly? It's like 51% mostly? What the hell's this? I guess some kind of anti-theft device? What is this supposed to represent? Even the eyebrows have numbers. You guys babbling about now? Hats. What you doing?
Whoa, you scared the daylights out of me. Don't sneak up on a fellow like that.
Wolcott?
Say, you wouldn't happen to be the inspector investigating Halcyon Helen's murder. You look like you might fit the bill.
Pretty observant.
Hey, I got it right. You must be a real top runner to be in charge of a case like this.
Nah.
Oh, wait. That's why you're talking to me. I'll help however I can.
It's actually you who started... No, it was me who started talking to you. Never mind. What? Yeah, I'd rather know who I'm talking to before I divulge any information.
Thelbert Wolcott, pilot house engineer, at your service. Forgive the impudence, but I'm still wondering who you are.
You figured it out.
Not many visitors out and about right now, aside from those damn Pteroray's.
You had already figured out who I was. What's that you're working on?
Ooh, this is my Pteroray grounder. Once it's working, it'll zap those winged sprats right out of the sky. Get it? Electricity? Grounding?
Mm-hmm. Why don't you shoot the Pteroray's?
Because the filthy little fleshbirds just keep coming back.
Fleshbirds?
But you help me get the parts I need to finish the Pteroray grounder, and the problem will take care of itself.
What's stopping you from getting them yourself?
I hate to admit it, but Pteroray's give me the heebie-jeebies, and most of the parts I need are surrounded by them.
What parts do you need?
I've got an incomplete list here, but I'm a tad on the scatterbrain side. You mind taking a look at my terminal to certify I ain't forgetting anything?
Scrap metal? What is all this?
I know, but trust me. Once I've got everything, I can build a zap trap that'll keep those disgusting things out of the engine.
I do have some things he wants, right? That's another quest. The Pteroray trap. Thelbert Wolcott asks you to help him construct an electric fence. Oh, it is calling it an electric fence. To protect the pilot house engines from Pteroray's. Find a half-melted battery. Thelbert needs a battery that is exactly half-melted. Find automech scrap. Thelbert needs scrap metal from a wrecked Sentry automechanical. We might have to wreck one ourselves to do that. Check Thelbert's terminal. Thelbert's terminal may reveal other items he needs for the fence. So there was an option came up that said I have some of the things he wants. Oh. I thought you were planning
You're
murder.
Back. Any luck finding what we need for the Pteroray grounder?
I don't know what I have, but yep. Here's what I found.
Thanks. I'll start working these things into my machine.
All the cables.
Come back when you found the rest, and we can get to Pteroray burning.
I guess.
You're back. Any luck finding what we need for the Pteroray grounder?
I guess that when we had checked his... Well, if we had checked his terminal, we'd see that the wires were something he needed. Shiny servo? It's not what you need, right? A servo?
You're back! Any luck?
Nope. So where's this terminal? Maybe in that room. I'm just gonna finish looking at the exhibits first. Finish that up. Are these those things? Those parasite thing? It is. They have that tail like that. So they have these things on display. Someone knows what they are. Think. Remember, when you leave, out of low gravity falls are high impact. Oh, when you leave low gravity, falls are high impact.
You know, I never imagined Spencer Woolridge would outlive Halcyon.
Oh, half-melted battery. Found a battery. Exactly, half-melted. Sorry, it's like 60% melted. It's not gonna be good enough. Spencer Woolrich and Terra One together for the last time. Free-range fixer, directed by Harriet Pilton Crumsworth. Watch the final adventures of Cascadia Burt on Terra One before it falls. Before the waves of the marauding philosophists. Starring Spencer Woolrich as Cascadia Burt, brought to you by Rizzo's Diet Lemon Slap. And that's the same. Oh, we've got a thing here. Giant Sprat. Gigantor. Stunt double, number 347. The legendary mount of Cascadia Burt, this is mount? He rides this thing? The frontier hero immortalized by... Yeah, I guess he is riding in the poster, right? Immortalized by Spencer Woolrich in Free Reign's Fixer, while the real Gigantor retired after filming and went to the home of a wealthy Byzantine collector, the ambitious shooting schedule and thrilling stunts of Free Reign's Fixer meant that many smaller-scale stunt doubles got to share the role of Gigantor. Number 347 displayed here, performed in a scene where Gigantor and Cascadia Burt, or Burt, right? Not Burt. I think I was saying Burt. Or buried in a rock slide. While her shot was ultimately cut from the film, her valiant sacrifice lives on here. Did you know? Gigantor was named after Rizzo's Gigantor energy drink, enjoyed on screen by Cascadia Burt while he battled against the vile philosophists. Yes, thirsty work, right? Prove your loyalty to Halcyon and try a Gigantor today. Available at a Rizzo's vending machine near you. I'm not going to be proving anything like that. Have no fear.
I can't believe Helen's gone. We're never going to get a sequel to Terror on Monarch.
Oh, look at that. Okay, we've come full circle then. Let's look around for this guy's laptop. I mean, well, terminal, whatever. Bard. Okay, we can't go in there. There's another door around this way, though. I think. There's stairs. This one, there was another door. No, just stairs, I guess. Alright.
Happy customers or repeat customers?
Yeah. You say that stuff in your sleep? Spork and forks. Is that what he needs? A collection of grease-stained spork and forks. If this battery were any more melted, it would be mostly melted. I'm pretty sure your spork and forks is another thing for him. He's gonna find his, terminal. Could it be this?
Greeting protocols initiating. Greeting protocols canceled.
Alright.
Phaeton cannot extend pre-programmed pleasantries at this time.
That's alright.
Error. Phaeton requires an attitude adjustment.
You mean your gyroscopic axis is misaligned?
Affirmative.
Why is no one fixing this?
After all this time in Halcyon, you still have to ask.
I didn't ask you, Max.
Captain Mabel Thompson is scheduled to perform routine realignment. Error. Captain Mabel Thompson is overdue to perform routine realignment.
Yeah, I'm getting that. Where is Captain Thompson?
Error. Phaeton cannot determine the whereabouts of Captain Mabel Thompson without gyroscopic realignment. Clarification of clarification. Phaeton must be realigned with the ship's internal gyroscope in order to calculate a flight path with an acceptably low margin of error.
Yeah, so it appears we're at an impasse then, but this is very bad. How have we not crashed?
Gyroscopic misalignment creates an increasing likelihood of a critical flight path error. Possible outcomes include steering the Eridanos atmospheric complex into a storm, resulting in the destruction of the Eridanos atmospheric complex.
That would be bad.
Steering the Eridanos atmospheric complex into a lower altitude, resulting in the extreme compression of the Eridanos atmospheric complex.
That would also be bad.
Steering the Eridanos atmospheric complex into a higher altitude, resulting in engine failure, followed by a rapid descent into a lower altitude, and the destruction of the Eridanos atmospheric complex.
Also bad.
Each of these outcomes represents an unacceptable violation of RISO's productivity standards for the Eridanos atmospheric complex.
Hold on, I want to ask that other thing.
Gyroscopic misalignment. Steering the Eridanos atmospheric.
What's the likelihood of this happening?
Response. Entropy is the eventual end state of all matter in the universe.
I don't mean that.
Error. Phaeton is unable to determine the likelihood of imminent catastrophe without gyroscopic realignment.
Okay, I get it. You can't do anything. So how do I fix this?
To achieve attitude adjustment, acquire the gyroscopic alignment key, or GAC, and convey it to the gyroscope management terminal in engineering.
GAC?
Utilize the GAC to interface with the gyroscope management terminal and execute the gyroscopic axial realignment procedure. This will achieve an attitude adjustment.
Okay, you're telling me... I was about to say I'm not qualified for this, but all I have to do is get a key and press a button on a terminal?
Affirmative.
But that's so simple.
Rizzos thanks you in advance for your assistance. Please note that Rizzos does not pay for uncontracted labor, but a member of HR will issue a favorable remark on your permanent record.
Oh, goody.
Access to engineering levels granted.
Oh. We have access to engineering.
Greeting protocols suspended. Checking for gyroscopic alignment. Error. Phaeton is suspending all non-critical functions pending gyroscopic realignment.
You guys are gonna get this realignment done, or what?
We're all family here. Rizzos takes care of its own.
Well, that just makes everything so much better. Oh, I was like, who the hell's that? Sometimes I don't recognize my own teammates. Guys are very loud and hummy and power sounds here.
Administrator Ludovico can seem intimidating, but he's a decent fellow. I know he cares.
These are takes. What about this? Can I pick it? I just picked it. Very nice, very nice. You've been playing this long, we're still picking up quests. Hi.
My last quarterly review said I had an attitude problem.
Oh, you too?
Morale improvement program fixed me right up.
Maybe this is that guy's terminal. Yes, it is. Pilot House Engineering, welcome, T. Wolcott. Messages. Pteroray trap. Walt, has the captain even read my proposal yet? I know she's not big on details, but so try this next time you talk to her. If I don't stop those Pterorays from nesting in the engines, there won't be a gyroscope for her to realign. Yes, I know that's a later problem. Don't mention that part. Thanks, Thelbert. And then Pteroray trap. Thelbert, good news. Okay. Vending machine power. Thelbert's terminal. I just gotta find auto mech scrap. All right. Good news. The plans are approved, and we're sending you the requested materials. You can find your cabling in the terraforming control room. We don't have any spare screwdrivers, but try some spork and forks. The dirtier, the better. A little grease actually helps loosen the screws. Regards, Walt. All right. It came from here, so there's nothing else on this platform. Well, except that those stairs there. I mean, not stairs. There's a door over there. Well, let me go back to Thelbert. Let's see. Oh, that caught my the light caught my eye. I guess I got one other thing for you: spork and forks.
You're back. Any luck finding what we need for the Pteroray grounder? Thanks. I'll start working these things into my machine. Come back when you found the rest, and we can get to Pteroray burning.
All right, so I thought that was my discrepancy thing, amplifier, saying it found something. All right, so what about these stairs then? So I don't know where we'd find automech parts, unless we need to bust. An automech. Alright, so this is back up where he came from. And then we want to go here to West Museum. Wait, this is where I've been. I've been here, okay. Yeah, he's riding the thing. That's right. Alright. So there's Phaeton control, and then there's the engineering. Does this go outside? Oh. Oh! Wait. The pilot house's astrogator needs a highly technical and critical fix, or it may eventually steer the Eridanos atmospheric complex into a disaster. Proceed to engineering. Take the elevator down to engineering. I've got everything except this guy's automechanical scrap. Right, so where's this elevator? it's not through there, it's down. I mean, is it under the stairs here? Oh! It's this. Alright, cool. Alright, we'll be going down next episode to the engineering section. Try to fix what's going on with the Phaeton here so it don't crash the... Well... So we don't crash all of this. Which is right now a pixelized mess. There you go. We don't want this whole thing to crash, alright? Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.